Hello friends, welcome back to our YouTube channel. I am Ashwini Garg. Today I discuss with you the topic of our class subject, class 11, and subject is business studies. Our today topic is employment and future of employment. Firstly, I explain with you what do you mean by employment. Employment refers to that economic activity under which people work for others and receive remuneration in lieu of their own. Means that it is an economic activity. Economic activity means that the motive behind to earn money. Under which people work for other. It is necessary that a particular person work under other person. Means that the relation between the two person will be the employer and employer. Owner and employee. And receive remuneration in lieu therefore. Means any type of the service which a particular person provide to the other person, then he will get some remuneration. Remuneration can be in the form of salary, wages, commission. Salary will be provided to the person who provide mental service, wages provide to the person who provide physical service, and commission will provide to the particular person who help us to increase the sale. Means we provide salary to the employees, we provide wages to the worker, labor, we provide commission to the salesman. So it is the employment. Means in business organization, every type of the facility will be provided. Means it refers to that economic activity under which people work for other and receive remuneration in lieu of their own. Now the features of employment. Features of employment. It is also said that characteristic of the employment and nature of employment. First one is service to others. Second one is personal service. Third one is agreement. Fourth one is no need of capital. Fifth one is servant. Sixth one is no risk. Seventh one is nature of employer. These are the seven features of the employment. Service to others, personal service, agreement, no need of capital, servant, no risk, and nature of employer. These are the seven features of the employment. Now I discuss with you all the features one by one. These are very easy concept. First one is service to others. Indication with the head point that in employment we provide service to someone under which we perform the task. Means in business organization, employee provide their service to the employer. So it is the first feature of the employment that it is necessary to provide service to the other person as well as to work under some other person. Means a particular organization, employees will perform their task under the employer and perform their task to the owner, employer, manager. Second one is personal service. इंडिकेशन विद द नेम दैट ऑल द सर्विस विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू बाय द पर्टिकुलर पर्सन मींस अ इंडिविजुअल पर्सन हु इज अपॉइंटेड एज अ एम्प्लॉय इन अ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ही विल प्रोवाइड द सर्विस नो वन कैन रिप्लेस इन द प्लेस ऑफ द पर्सन एवरी टाइम ही विल प्रोवाइड द सर्विस सो इट इज द पर्सनल सर्विस नो वन कैन प्रोवाइड द सर्विस इन द प्लेस ऑफ द अदर पर्सन थर्ड वन इज एग्रीमेंट इन एम्प्लॉयमेंट देयर इज सम कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एग्रीमेंट अमंग वेरियस पार्टीज लाइक एज द एम्प्लॉयर एम्प्लॉय इन बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मोर एम्प्लॉयज आर अपॉइंटेड सो इट इज नेसेसरी टू क्लियर एवरी टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन अमंग द वेरियस टाइप ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयज एंड एम्प्लॉयर सो देयर इज अ एग्रीमेंट अमंग द एम्प्लॉयर एंड एम्प्लॉय एंड बिटवीन द एम्प्लॉयर एंड एम्प्लॉय अबाउट द सैलरी अबाउट द वर्किंग आवर्स अबाउट द सेंशन ऑफ द लीव मेनी मोर मीन्स इट इज द थर्ड फीचर ऑफ एम्प्लॉयमेंट दैट देयर इज अ एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द एम्प्लॉयर एंड एम्प्लॉय अबाउट वेरियस टाइप ऑफ द सर्विस वेरियस टाइप ऑफ द कंडीशन फोर्थ वन इज सर्वेंट सर्वेंट इज द पर्सन हु परफॉर्म देयर ड्यूटी हु परफॉर्म देयर टास्क टुवर्ड इज ओनर इन बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन द एम्प्लॉयज विल प्रोवाइड देयर सर्विस अंडर द ओनर एज वेल एज द एम्प्लॉयर द ओनर एम्प्लॉयर एनीथिंग विच दे वॉन्ट टू परफॉर्म बाय अ पर्टिकुलर एम्प्लॉय देन The employee will perform that task in the same manner in which a manner owner wants to do. Owner wants to perform from employee side. So, it is a servant. Servant is the person who perform every task according to the interest, according to the demand, according to the order of the owner. So, employee is a servant because he performs a task according to the order of the owner, according to the interest, according to the wish of the owner. Employer. So it is the fourth feature, servant. No need of capital. In employment, there is no need of capital which make investment by the employee. Every type of the investment, every type of the capital invested by the owner in the business organization. The particular employee does not provide any type of the amount to start a business, does not provide any amount to running the business. So, employees only provide their service and get remuneration in lieu of their service. So, it is not necessary to the employee to provide any type of the capital for start a business, to running a business, to grow a business. Next one is No risk. When a particular employee does not make any type of the investment in the form of capital, then there is no risk about the bad debts of the money, about the loss. So, there is no any type of the risk. Risk is arise when a particular amount invested by the person. In business organization, the capital is invested by the employer or owner. No capital is invested by the employee. If employee does not invest any type of the amount in the business as a capital, then there is no risk in the form of bad debts, in the form of loss. Last one is nature of employer. Employer is the person under which a particular employee perform their task. The employer will be government institution, government enterprise or private institution, private enterprise. The employer will be anyone, government enterprise, private enterprise. The employee will perform their task under someone. The someone is known as employer. The employer is either government enterprise, private enterprise. So it is the last feature of the employment, nature of employer. Today I discuss with you the meaning of employment and the feature of employment. I hope it's clear to you. Thanks. Have a nice day.